हेलो एवरीवन, लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद द सेकेंड चैप्टर एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ रूल ऑफ ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी इन इंडिया. सो नाउ वी विल बी सीइंग अबाउट द ट्रेड बिटवीन इंडिया एंड अदर नेशंस. सो हाउ द ट्रेड रिलेशंस वेर गुड और बैड विद द इंडियंस. सो ऑन दोज डेज बंगाल वॉज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट वेल्थीएस्ट कंट्री. सो ओडिशा एंड बिहार ऑल्सो वॉज अंडर इट. ओके, बिकॉज it was over ruling or it was under it because it was a wealthy country. So the foreign trade took place at that time. A lot of things were happening in within the Bengal. All the foreign traders were buying a lot of things from this state. So in this period, the agriculture, trade growth of industries and high revenue income took place along with Dhaka, Patna and Murshidabad, which were the main trade center. So a lot of revenue, the high revenue income tax was taking place in these places, Murshidabad, Patna and Dhaka. So, and these were also the main centers of tradings. So the trading means all the businesses going up and down from one country to the another country. So after the death of Nawab of Bengal, Ali Wardi Khan, so he was the Nawab of Bengal and most powerful Nawab, and his son. So after the death of Ali Wardi Khan, his son Sirajuddaula became Nawab of Bengal in the year 1756. So after the death of he took the Nawabship. His son took the Nawabship in the year in 1756. So when he became the Nawab, these Britishers and the French people misused the power. They were going against this rules of the empire or whatever trading rules they had. So the Sirajuddaula, he was trying to stop them, but they did not listen to him. They went against him and they declared the war, or they declared the fight against him. So here the son of Ali Wardi Khan, the new Nawab Sirajuddaula, was defeated by the Britishers and the French, because they came together and they defeated him because he was trying to stop them from doing or collecting lot of illegal taxes from the people. So in that way they declared the war, and this war was won by the Britishers and the French people, and the battle was given the name Battle of Plassey. So this battle, the 23rd June, in the Battle of Plassey, so this ended there. So what happened then, so what did these Britishers benefit from this, from the Battle of Plassey, after defeating this Sirajuddaula, the Nawab of Bengal? What did they do? And how did they benefit from this? So the British had a great benefits from this, the great financial gain from this Battle of Plassey, because now they themselves chose the Nawab Mirzafar. Okay, Nawab of Bengal, this is Mirzafar, and they collected lot of wealth, lot of trade facilities were given freely from this Mirzafar. They were doing their own, because now they chose this Nawab from by themselves, right? So now he cannot say anything, but he also was not happy with that. So the Nawab Mirzafar could not bear this interference in the financial demands for a long time. So they were trying to do this lot of corruptions for a long time, but he was not happy with that. So he was trying to stop these people, but he got betrayed. He got dethroned from the Britishers, means he was removed from the post of Nawabship. They now removed him and they made somebody else. So in the place of Mirzafar, now they appointed Mir Qasim. Okay, so another Nawab, they appointed Mir Qasim to become their Nawab. of Bengal. So the Nawab of Bengal, this Mir Qasim, also had same problem there. Again, they collected lot of revenue and gave him a permanent authority to collect revenue from Chandgaon, Wardha, Bidnapur districts and all. So they are collecting simply like that. Now they made has a permanent authority to collect revenue. So this Mir Qasim also was not able to do or not able to bear that same problem here, and he also tried to stop them, and he put lot of restrictions for all this trading foreign trades. So he put foreign trade restrictions. So now nobody can take these taxes and nobody can collect that right. He put the taxes, or he had to the people, those who are working in the industries, they had to pay the taxes instead of collecting taxes from the people. So this made a very great impact on the Britishers for their trading, because now where they were not getting any benefits, because they grew a lot of tensions among themselves and they were not having any other ways to stop this. So the Mir Qasim, he has made this thing into a very strict way, that no Britishers may do these corruptions or whatever things they were doing wrong against these people collecting tax simply. Now they had to stop here. So now Mir Qasim alone cannot do this, because now they will collect their own armies and they will again come to fight with this, because they had done with different Nawabs like Mir Qasim, Mir Zafar and all. So now what this Mir Qasim did, he together called these Nawabs, all the Nawabs who were previously with them, Siraj ud-Daulah and all. So they made one group, and Mughal Emperor Shah Alam too, all jointly formed a common army against these Britishers, because they were always winning and they had a great other techniques or other weapons to beat this any army. So everyone came together and they tried to stop these Britishers. So in 1764 there was a battle between them, and this battle is called Battle of Buxar, okay, in Bihar. So these Britishers won this battle again. So the Britishers had very advanced weapons, guns and all, so that's why they were not able to win against them, and instead they had lot of other tricks, other armies who were following them. So this battle ended with the truce treaty at Allahabad. So thus the Battle of Buxar finished the incomplete intentions of the Battle of Plassey. So these Nawabs were trying to stop these Britishers from that, the first battle that had happened in the Battle of Plassey with Siraj ud-Daulah, after defeating him, and they were overruling gradually. So they tried to stop these Britishers, but they failed here in that thing. So now here also they have won the Battle of Buxar, and they signed the treaty, the truce treaty at Allahabad. So what will be the next consequences or situations for these Nawabs? So Siraj ud-Daulah was again made the Nawab of Awadh, but Britishers got permission to do free trade there. So he was made a Nawab again, but now he cannot say anything. He has to give the freedom to do the trading in that places. So whenever required, the troops of Awadh had to help these armies. So this was the treaty signed, the agreement. The treaty means if the opposite team is losing, they had to sign one agreement that now we can do this, you cannot say anything. So that type of treaty they had signed here. So now they can do trading in that places, and they also can take the soldiers of Awadh, of Siraj ud-Daulah, for any problems of happens, of any war happens with other Nawab. So the English got permission to do all the taxations on Bengal, Bihar and Orissa by collecting the tax by Diwani, they call it Diwani. So collecting the tax. So by this way the Britishers' monopoly was established means they now one empire means one man ruling. In that cases now it's happening with the Britishers, the monopoly rule means one person ruling the whole people there or the whole area there. So that was established, but did not rule these places. They could not do this much. This kind of rule was known as dual rule, which was so this kind of rule was called a dual rule that was established in the Bengal. So now Britishers also can rule there and other Nawabs also can rule, but most of the things were going against this Britishers. So they were imposing more things from themselves, but this Nawabs cannot do it anything. So now we'll be seeing what is this dual rule. Okay, so what do you mean by dual rule? So the taxation in Bengal, Bihar and Orissa was easy due to the Treaty of Allahabad, because they have signed the treaty, because they have signed the agreement that we can do trading, we can do all the businesses in these places, Bengal, Bihar, Orissa. So now they cannot say anything. It was becoming very easy for these Britishers. So they got protection of law. So they got protections and large troops of soldiers. So now they have also agreement that if anything happens, we get support from these Britishers. Sorry, we will get all the support from your armies, from your soldiers. So they were having a lot of safety now. So on the contrary, the Mughal king had to look after administration, management, economic power and protection were in the hands of the English rulers, and responsibilities were in the hands of Mughals and Nawabs. But then also they were dependent on Britishers. So all the things now, it was for them, they had to see their management, whatever protection they need, they have to give. So that is called a dual rule. Now one cannot rule for their own sake, but they had to rule, they had to combine together and they had to do. But the agreement, but the more thing that were getting again going for these Britishers, only Britishers were ruling more than these Nawabs. Everything they are getting freely from this Nawab, all the Britishers that things that they were given by the Nawab, the army of the Nawab, all the things provided for these people if they are in need of the armies, everything they had to give to these Britishers. So this were the Treaty of Allahabad signed. So now we see what are the effects of the dawal rule. So now we see that we have seen that there was a dawal rule, dawal system in Bengal. So what was the effect after this? So what happened then? The revenue collection means the land revenue collection from peasants. So all the peasants means those who do businesses. Okay, so was based on annual supports or was based on annual production of crops. So this peasants, all the business people, they had to give the taxes of the annual production means yearly production. But what happened now, this English started collecting revenue on the basis of land area. So if you have big area, you have to give more land. So in that cases now they are taking different collections of style of collecting different system of collecting revenue, I mean tax of those who have more land, they have to give more taxes. So the revenue collection started on contract basis so that they could collect taxes at the cheaper rate and the defined annual income from the company could be earned. So the contractors used to collect taxes according to their wishes and only a certain amount was paid to Britishers. So what happened? So these Britishers appointed some of the tax collectors, okay, so that they can collect the people from all the peasants and they can give to the Britishers. But here one person in the middleman, one who is collecting taxes, what he used to do? He used to collect more taxes from these peasants, and what he used to do? He used to give half part from for himself, and he used to give less money to these Britishers. So what happened? These patients were heavily suppressed by contractors and the company workers on those days. So these patients had to pay the lot of problem. These patients has to face a lot of problem with these collectors, all the contractors, collectors who were collecting money from these, who were collecting revenue from these people, were facing a lot of problems because they are supposed to collect whatever amount was fixed by the Britishers and the Nawabs. But here these middle people, the contractors, they are collecting more money and they are not giving the same amount to these Britishers, but whatever money, extra money, they are keeping for themselves. So this Bengal faced a heavy famine, but then also peasants were taxed very harshly by contractors. So a lot of problem was happening. Sometimes the crops were not growing, or sometimes the business was not happening well. Then also these collectors were not thinking about these people and collecting more and more taxes. So in 19th June 1773, Regulating Act was passed in the Parliament, and Warren Hastings was appointed as the new governor of Bengal. So the new governor came in this area for their looking after all this area of Bengal. So the Bengal was the main center of the British rule, and the Kolkata was its capital. So Bengal was the main center. These Britishers were ruling from mainly from the Bengal, and because in Bengal every other states are coming under it. So after taking charges, the governor Warren Hastings, what did he do for the people of Bengal? So the frequent conflict started between Hastings and the different rulers of India. So Warren Hastings, after he came, lot of conflicts, lot of fights were happening between the rulers. So he opted different policies as the time demanded. So he used to bring new policies, new things to solve the problem of the people over there. So like friendship, war, treaties, and with the states like Awadh, Mysore and Marathas. So in this way he brought lot of different treaties, different agreement. So in this way he made his position very strong in Bengal by extending their friendly relation with Awadh. So in this way he made lot of friendly relations, and he made himself very strong, his position, whatever power he has got, he has made more firm to build a very strong empire, or to strong governing system there. So on the order, on the other hand, he fought at war with Mysore King Hyder Ali and forced him to sign a treaty with them. So these people, this another king or another empire or another Nawab of Mysore. So we see that the king of Mysore, King Hyder, was against them. So here the Warren Hastings, the governor of Bengal, started doing something that with the people to stop his thing, but he was coming in middle. So he fought against them, and he forced this Hyder Ali, the King Hyder Ali, to sign the treaty with them to bring in a relation, to do the work with a unity and with togetherness. Okay, so the first British Mysore War. So the first British Mysore War in 1767 to 69 ended with the Madras Treaty. So here he forced the Hyder Ali to sign the treaty, and it was successful. So this treaty, the main cause was protecting each other on foreign attacks. But when Peshwa attacked Mysore British, so did not help Hyder Ali. So he was defeated in the war. So as a result, in the 1780s, one more war took place. The second war ended in 1784 with Mangalore Treaty. So English had to face drastic economical problems through the result of war was similar for both sides. So after the death of Hyder Ali in the year 32 years old, his son Tipu Sultan became the next ruler of Mysore. So he was an intelligent and brave soldier. So he was a scholar, and he knew different languages. Tipu Sultan was having friendly term with French and Turks. That was the reason why English were against him and opposed him when he attacked Travancore. So in the year 1792, Tipu Sultan lost the war because English were supported by Nawab Nazim and Marathas, and he had to sign the Srirangapatnam treaty with English. So according to this treaty, Tipu Sultan was given half of his kingdom and the 3 crores of the rupees as compensation for the loss so he had in the battle. So we see that a lot of battle is taking place between these people with the Britishers, because they were differentiating between these Britishers and French and Turks, because now this we see that Britishers were not having any good relations with the French and Turks, so they were against each other. But this Tipu Sultan, what he used to do, he used to have a close contact with them. That's why the Britishers did not like, and they came with the war, and they finally he has to sign the treaty. So in the year 1798, when Lord Wellesley became Governor General of India, then the second phase of British India came into effect. So they introduced the policy of two governing system or the bodies, which is known as the subsidiary treaty system in the history of India. So this treaty had been designed for two purposes. So what are they? To protect the restricted area under the company, and the second one to make the barricades of trustworthy Indian states around the company rule. So how will British get success in this purpose through the subsidiary treaty? So we see they have, so these two treaties help them to bound the boundaries, the areas that they had made for the trading companies. No other companies would allow to trade in that area. So they made a subsidiary, protection, restricted areas for the company. So second, they made the subsidiary boundaries to trust and Indian worthy states around the company rule. So they made some barricades. So they made some boundaries in the another case, barricades, like we say, the boundaries for their own ruling company.